The ongoing hell for commuters continues as talks aimed at resolving a long-running dispute over the roller conductors have broken down without agreement. In this edition of A Story Unfolds, we aim to cover the RMT picket outside Brighton Station. However, due to strikes and overrunning engineering works, I was left without a cameraman as he was stuck at London Bridge. When he did eventually get down, we grabbed a chat with RMT's Gary Hassel.
Govia, the Thameslink Railway, offered a proposition that seemed to be something that you would accept. So what actually happened there? Because talks have broken down, haven't they?
Yeah, the talks broke down yesterday. I don't think they took too long to break down. Is we've got the Charles Horton from GTR saying one thing to the media and the public. There's a solution by having a second person on the train. And yet when he meets the trade unions, he shifts away from that.
So you're saying they say one thing in public and one thing...
More faces in the town hall clock is the sort of thing that I'd say. Is, they're saying one thing to one person, one thing to another, one person to the politicians, one person to the trade union.
So what's planned in the future for the union and in the talks?
Yeah, well, as I stand here today, I don't believe there's any more talks planned. As you know, we set a series of strike and dispute dates that run through until the 8th of December. Until our members tell us otherwise, or until our leadership get an agreement with the employer, we'll carry out that instruction. So we've just finished the 3 days this week, and our members will go back to work. And then we'll, unless something significantly changes or we reach some sort of agreement, we'll be back here next Tuesday.
So after speaking to Gary, I think it's time to speak to Govia Thameslink.
But it was easier said than done. I phoned and emailed, but I was told they were unable to accommodate my request. Instead, I headed to a local cafe to catch up with Summer Dean about her successful Southern Justice campaign, which aims to fund a legal challenge against Southern Rail.
So, Summer, last time that we saw you was at the Southern Justice demonstration. You hadn't quite raised all the money, but you have now.
Yeah, so we had incredible support throughout the 30 days that we were crowdfunding. And, you know, we've now raised £26,290. So we exceeded the target. So we're still waiting on documents that we asked the Department of Transport for, and hopefully they'll be coming out to us by the beginning of November. And right now we're focusing on the health and safety risks and whether those are being monitored.
Also this week, the Select Committee report blasted the government, Southern and the RMT for their respective roles in the disruption.
So the Select Committee's report has just come out. Very interesting. What do you think about it?
So, indeed, the Select Committee report that she came out was very interesting, and it really, what that's essentially done is confirmed and completely validated everything that we've been saying in the past 5 months. We've been saying we need transparency from the Department of Transport. That is written there in black and white.
For a further update, join us next week on A Story Unfolds. This is Jodie Doherty-Cove for Latest TV News.